Thank you, Deputy Pringle.
Thank you, Ken Corla. Taoiseach, as we organise ceremonies to mark the centenary of 1916 and the ensuing War of Independence, the continuing European crisis looms forbidding as a backdrop. And our debate in this country has always been skewed by follow-the-money mantras, which deflect from what could be the bigger master plan. And like in the treaty negotiations, when Lloyd George described negotiating with De Valera as trying to pick up mercury with a fork, the federalisation of Europe debate, one of rational thoughts, views and opinions, is like trying to pick up mercury as well. Taoiseach, are we being sleepwalked into a federalised Europe? And if so, what do the Irish sovereign people think of this? And is it something that we want? Federalism will downgrade Ireland to a province of Europe and consequently downgrade Leinster House to a very nice but in effect county council office. With economic policies being the starting block for building a federal Europe, what are we looking at, and are we being played by the Pied Piper of Europe down a road that we may relinquish our sovereignty completely? I think, Taoiseach, that this debate needs addressing, and would like to hear your views on what many would see as veiled plans to federalise Europe, and how Ireland may well be set to reverse to Dominion status of 1949, this time to Europe rather than to the Commonwealth.
Thank you, Deputy.
Taoiseach. The answer to your question is no. Ireland is not going to be walked into any federalisation of Europe. That was rejected by people on more than one occasion. What's required here is to make political decisions, both within the Eurozone and at a European level, to deal with the European banking crisis in the first instance, and look at where the union of 500 million people expects to be in the next 10 years. The opportunities that exist there through the single market, development of the single patent digital market, and the opportunities for concluding trade agreements outside the European Union means so much potential for this country, which is an exporting nation. So your question is this country going to be walked into a federalised Europe? The answer is no.
Deputy Pringle.
Taoiseach, I'd like to thank you for your very clear and definitive answer and stating no. And I certainly will hold you in the House to that answer. But the debate constantly over the last number of months has totally been about further integration, further fiscal union. Angela Merkel says that we can't have a solution unless we get to that full fiscal union in advance of that. So are you going to tell Angela Merkel in Germany that the Irish people are not for a federal Europe, and that the Irish people aren't going to be walked down this road into giving up our sovereignty completely and following the lead of Germany and France and the way that they are dictating the pace and the union in the future? So, Taoiseach, will you bring that message out to Europe, and will you tell Europe that the Irish people are not for a full federalised Europe and not for full integration, and that the Irish people will retain their sovereignty into the future?
Thank you, Deputy. The
European leaders are very well aware of Ireland's position here. Ireland's voted over the years in respect of European Union treaty after European Union treaty, and Irish people have made their decisions very clear on that, no more than the recent one of a 60-40 decision in respect of fiscal stability, the Fiscal Stability Treaty. And that's what this is about consolidating and about strengthening the euro within the eurozone. I answered a question yesterday saying we support in principle the question of a banking union, which is something that would be in every country's interest in having a streamlined, efficient, working banking system across all countries in the eurozone. So European leaders are well aware of the importance of sovereignty in a country like this. They're well aware of our attitude towards a federal Europe. And let me repeat again to you, your first question was, are we being sleepwalked into something here for a total federal Europe? The answer is no.
Thank you. That completes the leaders' questions for today.